Hello everyone, welcome back to History Notes, the place with the perfect science lessons, and today I'm here with the first part of the chapter, Transportation in Plants and Animals. In today's chapter, we'll be discussing about the flow of substances through the body in different organisms and what is the need of this flow. Let's begin. Let's first talk about the human body. So, blood is the fluid which flows in blood vessels and it transports digested food from small intestine to all parts of the body. We had learnt in the chapter of nutrition in organisms that the villi in the small intestine absorb the nutrients from the food and then it passes into the blood for transportation. Second function of the blood is that it carries oxygen from lungs to all cells of our body after respiration. And third, it also transports waste for the removal from the body. The three functions are that it transports digested food and it carries oxygen, also it transports waste. Blood consists of a fluid called plasma, and plasma contains red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets. Let's discuss each of these in detail. Red blood cells or RBC, this red blood cells contains a pigment, it is called hemoglobin. And this hemoglobin binds with oxygen to transport oxygen to all parts of the body. Also, due to the presence of hemoglobin, the blood is red in color. So hemoglobin transports oxygen to all parts of the body, plus it gives the blood its red color. Then we have the white blood cells or WBC, and their main function is to fight against germs which enter our body. Then the plasma contains platelets which help in clot formation. You might be thinking, what is this clot formation? Well, when you get hurt, the blood starts coming out of the body. But after some time, you notice that a reddish brown thing covers the part where it was bleeding and prevents further flowing of blood. This prevents the further leakage of blood, and this is called clot formation. So this is the function of platelets. Now let's move on to the next slide. Alright, now there are two types of blood vessels in the body. One is arteries, the other one is veins. Arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from the heart to all parts of the body. So the arteries are carrying oxygen-rich blood. And mostly this is transported from the heart to the body parts. Blood flow is rapid and at high pressure. So the walls of the arteries are thick and are elastic. The veins are completely opposite. They carry carbon dioxide rich blood from all the parts of the body back to the heart. And unlike the arteries, the veins have thin walls because blood in the veins is flowing under low pressure. So by now you might have guessed that the heart from the arteries pumps oxygen rich blood to the organs, and from there the veins carry back the carbon dioxide rich blood to the heart. Now that the heart has come into the picture, let's look at it in detail. Heart is an organ which beats continuously. It acts as a pump to transport blood to all parts of the body, and blood carries other substances along with it. The heart has four chambers. The two upper chambers are called the atria, and the two lower chambers are called ventricles. The upper chambers, there are left and right, and the lower chambers also left and right lower chambers. And the upper ones are called atria, and the lower ones are called ventricles. The partition between these chambers helps to avoid mixing up blood which is rich in oxygen with the blood which is rich in carbon dioxide. So what this states is that the chambers of the heart are separated by thick walls, and this prevents the flow of blood from one chamber of the heart into the other chamber of the heart. Let's move on to the next slide. Now you might be thinking that there are four chambers of the heart. How exactly does the blood flow? To understand the flow of blood, we first have to keep a few points in mind. First point, that the right side always has impure blood or the blood which is rich in carbon dioxide, and the left side has pure blood. Left side of the heart is separated from right side by a thick muscular wall, and this is called septum. This prevents the blood from the left side going into the right and blood from right side coming into the left. The heart always receives blood from veins into the upper chambers, which is the atria. So the blood, no matter pure or impure, is always taken into the upper part of the heart. And the blood is always pumped out from the lower part of the heart, which is the right or the left ventricle, into the arteries. Now these arteries take pure blood from the heart to the body parts, and the veins bring impure blood from the organs to the heart. Arteries always carry blood away from the heart, and veins always bring blood to the heart. So when you put all this together, you realize that the pure blood taken in is from the left auricle or the left atrium. So auricle or the upper part can also be known as atrium. Both these terms can be used, auricle or atrium. And then the pure blood is given out from the left ventricle. So like I said, pure blood is always on the left side. So taken is from the upper chamber, means pure blood taken in from upper left chamber, pure blood given out from the lower left chamber. And then the impure blood which is taken in is from the right auricle, means the upper right part of the heart. And the impure blood given out is from the right ventricle. Right side always has impure blood, so it is the impure blood is taken in upper part of the heart, upper right. And the impure blood given out is from the lower right part of the heart. And it is due to this reason that the veins are connected to the upper part, which is the atrium, and the arteries are connected to the lower part, which is the ventricle. Because veins are always bringing in, and the blood is taken in from the atrium's upper parts, and the arteries are always taking out, and the blood is given out from the ventricles or the lower parts. So please remember this point for the next video, and in the next video we are going to be using all these points to see from which part of the heart, through which artery or vein the blood flows, during what time. So for that these points are really required. And here is a preview of what you are going to be seeing in the next video. There are two vena cavas, the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cavas. These are the veins. And these both vena cavas end into the right atrium. So the blood is now in the right atrium.